going to apply the first law to two closed systems and then compare the final results. One's a constant pressure system, piston and cylinder. The pressure is 0.5 megapascals. The other is a fixed volume cylinder. They both contain one mole and they're starting at the same temperature, same pressure. So they're starting at the same volume. We want to know what's the final temperature and the final pressure in each container after we add 8.5 kilojoules of heat to each system. And so the first is the container A, the constant pressure system. So just so we have a representation, what we're looking at is a piston with constant weight, and we're adding heat. We're starting at 350 Kelvin, 0.5 megapascals, and the heat we're adding is 8,500 joules. We'll work everything in joules. And so the first law, closed system, change in internal energy is heat plus work, and the change in internal energy is CV delta T for an ideal gas. Independent of the type of process, that's what is equal to Q, of course, is a fixed number. Work is minus pressure times the volume change. And since we're dealing with ideal gas, we can take advantage of the ideal gas. We're at constant pressure, so minus delta P dV is the same as delta PV because pressure is constant. Because this is an ideal gas, working with one mole, this is the same as delta RT, which R is constant, so that's R delta T. So I can make that substitution into the first law, and I can rearrange. So minus R delta T, so let me bring this to the other side. Now CV plus R is equal to CP for an ideal gas. So now we can find the final temperature. Let me substitute the values. So keep in mind we're working with one mole, so if you like we could, CV would have number of moles in front of it, which is one, so the units cancel, and I can solve this equation for the final temperature. So the final temperature, and of course the final pressure is the same as the initial pressure. So let's do the same calculation over here for the constant volume system. And constant volume means there's no work. So delta U is Q plus W. That's zero. Delta U is the same as before. CV is CP minus R. So CP is 31. R in the correct units. So we have everything in joules per mole Kelvin. T2 minus T1 equals Q. So let's substitute in the values. CP is 31, R 8.314, both units joules per mole Kelvin. T2 minus 350 equals 8,500 joules. So I can rearrange and solve for the temperature. End up with the final temperature of 725 Kelvin. And then I can use the ideal gas law. Because volume's constant, I can get the final pressure is RT1 over P1. Well, R's cancel, I can rearrange that P2 is equal to P1, T2 over T1, 0.5 megapascals. 725 over 350, P2, 1.03 megapascals. I'll write that significant figures, 1.0 megapascals. So the pressure essentially doubled. Now notice the temperature is significantly higher for the constant volume process, about 100 degrees higher, because in the constant pressure process here, some of the energy, some of the heat that was added went into work, which was removed from the system. The rest went to raising the temperature, increasing internal energy. In the constant volume system, all the energy, all the heat added went into raising the temperature, increasing internal energy, and therefore the temperature is higher.